1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Continuing with our database from last time. We saw last time how to create a form in the weight database. I'll click on the weight database here. And it will open in Access 2010. This is the form that we made last time. So if you give it to a user, they don't want to see the query and they don't want to see the table. They only want to see the form. So this is how you set it up for that. First, you create a form, a blank form. And you can call it FRM menu, form menu. Okay. And on that form, you create a button in the top left corner. And you, when that button is pressed, you want to quit the application. That means close Access entirely. And I'll click on Finish, and there it is. Now, we can also add a title to this form that says what it is, like weight database. And we can add a button to open this the form that we have, the weight form. Form, open, next. This is the form, next. Open the form and show all the records. And we can say text here, and we'll say weight form here. And well, you could give it a meaningful name like CMD, open FRM weight. I don't normally bother doing that, but you could do that. And there's your form. So if we next we want a macro, I'll close this form. It's waiting here. Do you want to save the changes? Yes. Now we've got our menu form. Now what we want to do now is create a macro to open that form automatically when the database starts. So we click on Create, and we click on Macro here, and we want a macro, and we want it to open a form. And the form name is form weight. And the next thing we want to do is maximize the window, meaning the form takes up the whole size of the screen. And we don't need to add another action after that, but we have to save this form macro. I'm right-clicking there on the tab there, so we want to save it, not as the default name, but as the special name, AutoExec, which means that it is automatically executed when the database is open, right? So you see there that there is a macro called AutoExec. You know it's a macro because it's got that little yellow scroll thing there. So now if I close this database, it's closed now. So if I open it again, I'll click on it. There it is, and it's automatically got those two buttons there. If I click on the wait form button, it automatically shows me the wait, right? So if I want to add a record, 54.4, I can add a record, right? And as long as I'm here, I can do a design thing here on this form to also add a button in the top left-hand corner of this form to close the form. Form operation, close, finish, right? And that's the picture of the arrow pointing to an open door. So now if I go back to form view, that button is there to close the form, and if I just click on it, it goes back to the main menu, and if I click on this, then it closes the entire database. So that's the lesson for today.